What's going on, everybody? It's Jay Coffee Talk tapping in, man. And we got to discuss this whole situation. I'm sure everyone sees this news trending heavy in the headlines right now regarding WAC 100 and actor Kenneth Lawson. And what do y'all think about this, man? This doesn't really seem to add up. You know what I mean? WAC may pay for this, though. WAC may pay for this. But one thing I want to point out, right, if WAC does indeed lose this lawsuit, okay, we know The Game, who WAC works with, you know, they're acquainted with the same people and whatnot, entertainment attorneys, people doing the books and all that. The Game has lost multiple lawsuits over the years, and we know The Game is like a pro at not paying people the money. I feel like it has caught up to The Game, though, you know what I mean? Where we've seen him have to, you know, put money in other people's names, essentially cook the books, retire from The Game. And looks like he's out here scamming now, but I don't know. He was running strong with it for years, not paying people these civil judgments that were placed against him. But that's besides the point. What I'm saying, when this don't really add up, this whole situation just sounds a little funny style. Like, do you guys agree or what? Because I'm sure you guys heard what the claims are. Kenneth Lawson's eating in a sushi joint back in 2019 in Hollywood, right? And says he's approached by WAC 100. Never met him before in his life. And he WAC's turning up on him and is like, yo, you were trying to talk to my wife. And then Kenneth's wife attempts to intervene. Doesn't work. WAC's still on 100. And steals off on him, knocks him out cold. He loses a couple teeth, jaws fractured in multiple spots. And when he, you know, was falling out, busted his head open, right? Now, I'm not saying the incident didn't happen. I'm just saying it just doesn't seem to add up. There's got to be more to the story, because he's just claiming, yo, I never met this guy before. And then he's running up on me, wilding out, talking about, you know, don't talk to my girl. And then he also has WAC sounding like a vicious, cold-blooded killer. You know what I mean? Because it's stating in these, you know, all these media outlets are rocking from the same reports that TMZ obtained in documents. You know what I mean? And in Kenneth's statements, he's basically saying, my wife tried to intervene. He stole on me, knocked me out. He almost attacked my wife. Like it says in there, like he almost laid a blow to his wife. People at the sushi joint, other customers had to intervene and restrain WAC. Although it doesn't seem WAC was ever arrested for this. Like no one called the police. There were no criminal charges sought. I'm sure we would have heard of that if that, you know, went that route. But now he's suing and he's coming off a little sue happy to me. Right. Like, let me know if you guys agree, because, OK, he's suing WAC. You know, pain and suffering, probably. They're saying it's an undisclosed amount of money that they're suing for. But, you know, injuries, pain and suffering. He's saying he lost jobs because of this. But how the hell is he going to go after Birdman? Because they're saying Birdman is named in the lawsuit as like someone that they're going after for money. And it's like, because Birdman, WAC was there promoting some Cash Money West business, artist Bree, like, okay, even if he was, I just don't understand how Birdman could be liable for that. You know what I'm saying? It's not like there was a Cash Money West event that took place and he was assaulted at the event or something like that. And he's saying, yo, Birdman, you were running this event. You should have had better security. I'm holding you liable for this. He's saying he was at some restaurant and, you know, socked him out. It's just, I don't know. This just is coming off a little funny style to me. And, I mean, let's keep it funky, right? WAC 100 is doing a lot of business. We know he has businesses. We know he's working with a lot of artists. He seems to be doing pretty well for himself. I'm not saying Kenneth Lawson is no slouch, but I don't think he's been out here getting paid like that. You know what I mean? I don't know. Like, it's kind of coming off that he just got beat up and he's like, yo, I'm going to turn this thing around on you. And take everything you got or something like that. I don't know. Everyone hit the comments and let me know your thoughts if you agree with me. The story just don't seem to add up, though, that he never met WAC. And then WAC is accusing him of speaking to his wife or something. It just something don't add up here. Now, WAC 100, you know, obviously a guy, he's very aware of what's posted online. Like, you know what I mean? We've already been over this numerous times. He's very aware of blogs. He's very aware of what's in the news cycle. You know, he'll try to put it out there sometimes like, oh, I could care less about this ish. But believe me, WAC 100 is very aware of all the trending topics, who's talking about them. And if the narrative ain't going his way, he's trying to intervene and change that. That's a fact. I proved that to y'all, right? So we know right as this news is really trending hard everywhere, WAC is posting this stuff up and he's saying, you know, don't disrespect me, then put boundaries on how I can disrespect you. And then he also said, this sums me up 100%. Throw a rock at me and I'll throw in a mountain back. Bet you'll know next time not to play with me. Now, it seems to me at the timing of when he's posting this that this would have something to do with this incident, as you know, this is all up in the news. So it seems to me like that's a response from WAC 100. I'm not saying it is 100% sure, but I'm sure, like, y'all let me know if you agree. It seems he is responding, and the way he's putting it out there is that there was some kind of disrespect going on. So I don't know, like, what can we make from this? Did this guy try to holler at WAC's wife on another occasion? Or is this just all BS? I don't know. This just seems funny style, but I feel like Kenneth Lawson is really trying to put on and play victim the correct way, right? Because listen, I'm not knocking anyone for suing anyone. I tell y'all all the time, guys, you know, I'm not no big tough guy. I'm not, you know, I don't play by the street rules and all that. You know what I'm saying? People sue people sometimes. You know, if you're just an actor, you ain't living that life like that and you get socked out, I mean, deal with it how you're going to deal with it. But I mean, did you do something to bring that upon you? I don't know. But what I mean when I'm saying he's playing victim correctly is that's the route he's going. He's trying to see a bag off this. He's got to play the victim role, right? Like, I never met this guy before. My wife tried to intervene. He hit me. He almost hit my wife. Other patrons in the restaurant had to step in. You know, WAC no stranger to fighting. We see him out here all the time fighting with people. And, you know, let's not lie, man. If, like, good example, let's not forget when Game and 40 Glock were going at it in court, the attorneys and the judge and everyone was constantly talking about social media posts. That was part of what hurt 40 Glock with the judgment he was obtaining, you know what I mean? Because he only got a fraction of what he was really trying to get, because the court said, yo, listen, you're coming in here talking about you suffer from PTSD and all that. You know, you're scared for your life. You're running around and hiding and you got to switch cars up because this guy has gang ties. Like, 40 Glock was saying this type of ish in court, right? But the court, they were like, come on, we see you on social media saying that you're a gang member. We see you on social media harassing this guy and making fun of his family, etc. Like, slow down with all that, you know? So Kenneth Lawson is really putting on in the victim role, and that's what you got to do if you're really trying to see a bag like that. So I don't know what happened, but I just wanted to break all this down with y'all a little bit. Tap in, let's talk. As you guys know, I'm always very interested to hear what everyone's got to say. If you're new, make sure to subscribe to the J Coffee Talk channel. Daily content, music, news, sports, current events, life, and much more. And I'm gone.